nonfiction and STEM fans. This is Kirsten Larson, author of the newly released A True Wonder, illustrated by Katie Wu. And today I'm here with another nonfiction or STEM book review. Today I am reviewing Two Grooms on a Cake, the story of America's first gay wedding. This is by Rob Sanders and illustrated by Robbie Cathro. So as a writer, the thing that really fascinates me about this book is the structure that author Rob Sanders uses. He's used a compare and contrast structure, comparing how you make a cake with how weddings come about. So here's the first page. Two grooms on top of a cake. That's us. Some thought it could never happen, and it almost didn't. But one day we stood in frosting on top of a three-tiered wedding cake. This is our story. So the story's told from the point of view of the two grooms that sat on top of the wedding cake. And on the very next page, Rob sets up that compare and contrast with between the cake and the two men who are getting married. So he says, every cake begins with a recipe. Ours did too. The recipe told exactly what was needed, down to the smallest pinch, and it gave instructions for every single step. But there are no recipes for weddings, but there are laws for marriages. Okay, and so then on each and every page, he talks a little bit about the process for making a cake and the process for meeting the love of your life, for falling in love, and for deciding that you want to get married. And I love Robbie Cathro's illustrations in this book. They really bring the whole thing to life. But if you are somebody using this book in the classroom, I think this is a really accessible way. The whole idea of a recipe and likening a recipe to marriage laws, I think it's a really accessible way to talk about gay marriage with students. And again, the POV of using these two grooms on the cake, that compare and contrast structure, it's really, as a writer, something that's really fascinating to me. So I highly recommend Two Grooms on a Cake. This is by Rob Sanders, illustrated by Robbie Cathro.